Joining me this morning from W Resources is Michael Masterman and Pablo Neira. Michael, Pablo, good morning. Nice to have you with us.
Great to be on Proactive, Andrew.
Michael, firstly, if we can kick off with you, a quarterly update out this morning, production-wise, how's the period been? Give us a bit of an update.
Well, we've discussed it probably about 2 months ago, but the June quarter was always going to be incredibly difficult. The shutdown of operations in April as a result of the state of emergency and the various challenges with the COVID-19. But look, the team's done a fantastic job keeping costs and cash management tight. We've been able to very successfully increase the amount of shipments to almost 100 tonnes, if you include both the tungsten and the tin. So that's a good outcome. Probably the highlight from the quarter is really good tin production, good tin recoveries. We've got some work to do cut out in front of us to get the tungsten recoveries up.
Why was the tungsten production down, Michael? What was feeding into that?
April was effectively a near zero month because the Spanish government is part of the... Yeah, and it seems not that long ago, but the Spanish government required us to shut down operations. We faced all sorts of movement constraints. We were very successful at shipping and moving tin and tungsten. So at the end of the day, what makes us money is making sure we can get the high quality tin and tungsten out of the plant and onto trucks. We've actually today, shipped two shipments of tin, and that's 40 tons of tin. So we're doing very well on the tin front. Tungsten, I think we've got a range of things that are underway that are gonna lift the tungsten. One of the changes, and perhaps this is a good time to introduce Pablo, is we've really taken the opportunity in this challenging environment to bring on some very key executive talent onto the team. So Pablo's moved into a executive position, driving our Spanish operations, being able to spend time as he is now down at the mine. We brought on a new plant manager, Danilo Diaz from Anglo-American, who's added a huge amount of value in terms of, operator discipline and performance. And so we're very pleased with how Danilo's fitting in. And there's a suite of both plant and mining optimization changes that we're driving through. But maybe let me introduce Pablo.
Well, indeed, yeah. Pablo, tell us exactly, you're on site there. Just tell us a little bit more about exactly where you are.
Yeah, good morning. Well, I'm here at La Parrilla in Extremadura. Behind me, you can see the plant. Over there, you'll see the primary. Just behind me, the jig. And at the bottom, the concentrator. The plant is running smoothly today. So,
Just how are things currently around the COVID-19 pandemic? What kind of challenges is that presenting you right now?
Although the state of emergency was lifted in June 21st, the situation in Spain is still complicated because there are still cases coming up in multiple locations. So we all have to still very alert and following, all these preventive measures that we have. Actually, at the plant, we have a very rigorous and controlled every day on all the equipment and all the people that coming into the plant. And so far, we have had no cases. So let's hope we can keep like this, going along.
And you've got a good team there with you on site at La Parrilla.
Yeah, exactly. As Michael pointed out before, we have reinforced our management team here with the new plant manager, Danilo. He's coming from Brazil and has more than 26 years of experience in mineral processing and has a proven plant manager track record on commissioning gravity plants and leading large management teams. So he arrived again at the beginning of June and he has already made an impact across all the organization and all the different departments.
And Pablo, just to add what Michael was saying a moment ago, can you tell us just a bit more about how production is currently?
We have currently two main priorities underway. One is, of course, to increase the recovery ratios and also to lift productions, while at the same time maintaining the production cost as low as possible. So to that extent, we have an intensive list of improvement actions that we are currently putting underway into the plant. And again, while making sure, you know, we remain, you know, with the lowest cost possible across the mine and the plant.
So are you, how are you feeling then about the next quarter and the rest of this year as far as production and what's happening on site?
Yeah, I'm convinced, I'm very optimistic about, you know, how things will perform, you know, for the rest of the year. We're currently seeing, you know, changes and small improvements, you know, both in the mine and in the plant that will lead to increased recovery ratios and productions. Yeah, I'm convinced that, you know, with the reinforced management team that we have now in place, with all this extensive list of improvements that we are currently putting into the plant, we are going to get, you know, to very to significant higher recovery rates of tungsten, and we already have in tin, and also to increase production.
Well, Michael, if I can bring you back in now, Pablo, he's optimistic on the outlook here. What's your assessment of what the future holds?
No, I definitely agree that we've got very positive future in terms of increasing tungsten production, as well as continuing to have extremely strong results on the tin. I think what Pablo just said, the team has done an extremely good job in these difficult conditions to keep costs really low. We're running at a strip ratio of 0.5 to 1. That's like half a ton of waste to every ton of ore that we get into the plant. That just keeps our mining costs incredibly low. We've got the operating team really tight, productive, led, good focused, but you know, we're really efficiently running this in a volatile global market, and that's what you want to be able to do. You want to be able to improve, but at the same time make sure that the operating cost of the plant is low, making sure we've got stronger and stronger teams driving the project forward. And look, it's I think we'll all look back on the June quarter as one we put behind us. But we're very much, as Pablo said, looking forward to this next half, and we've got lots of things that we'll do to improve things.
And Michael, you've received some funds from the Spanish banks, have you?
Yes. So the Spanish government, as part of the COVID response, put in a Spanish government guarantee program where the banks are guaranteed 80% of their loans as part of the program. We were successful. We got a total of, I think, 1.8 million euros in place. That involved extension of existing facilities, which is always good, way up to 5 years. So no pressure for any repayments on those. And some good fresh funds at very competitive interest rates. So, you know, we're talking about 2 to 3%. So if we can draw that kind of funds and that kind of access, drive the production upwards, we're looking good, and we're looking forward to getting out of this COVID thing.
Good to get an update. Michael, Pablo, thank you.
It's a pleasure. Good to see you, Andrew.